Jesus deep down in my heart. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Amen. I will extol thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Father, in Jesus' name, we come on this morning saying thank you, Lord, for another day, God, that you blessed us to see. Another opportunity, oh God, to come before you, your presence, oh God, with singing, God, with praise, God, with your word, God, that you be glorified, that you be edified. We say thank you on this morning, oh God. God, we ask you, oh God, to bless, oh God, all the hearers, oh God, all those that are tuned in, oh God, whether it be by Facebook, YouTube, oh God, even the teleconference. We ask you to bless them this morning, oh God. Sing from your word.
Yeah.
praise his name. Yes. How many out there love to praise his name? Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. We ought to give him a praise right now. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. We glorify you. We magnify your name. Yes. Hallelujah. At this time, it's our time for giving, and we ask you, all that are listening by Facebook, all that are listening through YouTube and the teleconference, be a part of Mount Calvary. Be a blessing to Mount Calvary. You're sowing in good ground. You're sowing seeds that will come up that profit much for the kingdom of God. And we ask you on this morning, if you see on your Facebook, you can hit the tithe key, a button, or if you want to, some people don't trust electronics and online stuff. You can bring your tithe by the church and drop it in the box or put it in this Faith's hand. But we ask you on today is to give. Yes. Give as God has blessed you. Yes. You will not regret it, because the song says that you can't beat God giving. No matter how hard you try, you cannot beat him giving. Amen. And at this time, if you have your offerings in your hand, we just ask you to lift it up to the Lord and just repeat after me. And it's just not a slogan, but you got to think about what we're saying on this morning. Yes. All that I have.
All that I have.
The Lord has provided.
The Lord has provided.
As an act of faith.
As an act of faith.
And obedience.
And obedience.
To the word of God.
To the word of God.
I prayerfully. And cheerfully.
And cheerfully.
Give my tithes.
Give my tithes.
And offerings.
And offerings.
And receive.
And receive.
My blessings.
My blessings.
From the Lord.
From the Lord.
Father, in Jesus' name, we come on this morning saying thank you, O God, for the tithes, for the offering, O God, for the praise, for the worship that we are giving back to you, O God. God, and we ask you to accept what we give to you, O God, as what we can give, O God. We thank you on this morning, O God, that you're blessing, O God, that you are making it more than what it seemed like. Because, God, when we put it in your hands, O God, you multiply, that it be used for your upbuilding of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I want to thank everybody for your giving on this morning, and that it's time for the word. So I want you to get your Bible.
Amen. Come on, let's just give God a hand clap of appreciation for being here with us, leading us and guiding us all the way. Yeah, Lord, prepare all of us to be a sanctuary. We want to thank Reverend Elaine Powell for doing such a wonderful job in leading us in worship. We want to thank our dear brother, Minister Ty Hamer, for teaching such a wonderful Sunday school. And thank our music ministry, Brother Thomas and Brother Trey, for always lifting up the name of Jesus in song.
Bless you, sir.
We also thank our fellows for working behind the scenes. Those you don't see, Brother Turner, Brother Cochran, we always give God praise for them.
Yes.
Keeping us online, keeping us focused,
amen.
Keeping the word of God coming to your homes. Amen. And we thank all of you, my father's children, for chiming in on our teleconference and by Facebook Live and our brush fire. And we say to all of our members and our covenant partners, grace and peace unto you from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
It is a wonderful Sunday in the neighborhood, and we're so glad that you and I know that we serve an awesome and mighty God that looked beyond our faults and saw our needs, and he woke us up early this morning, and here we are in the worship experience saying, praise you, Lord. We thank you for your goodness, and we thank you for your kindness. Amen. Just wanted to remind all of our members and the people in our neighborhood and our covenant partners around the region that on the second Sunday in May at 10:45, of course, we will be celebrating our mothers on our Mother's Day parking lot service. And we ask that all of you that may not have a church that you're going to attend but want to celebrate your mothers with us, please come out here at Mount Calvary, 318 Denmark Street here in Goldsboro, North Carolina. And like I said before, we got a great big parking lot out there that can hold a lot of cars and a lot of people. And so we want you to come and celebrate with us on that second Sunday in May at 10:45 a.m. We're going to start the music ministry, and our all women's choir, mother's choir, will be singing. We have a wonderful guest preacher that's coming from Wadesboro, North Carolina, Minister Barbara Thomas. Her and her family will be here to break the bread of life. And we're going to announce and celebrate all the mothers of Mount Calvary, those who are living and those who may be deceased. And also we're going to celebrate the mothers of our surrounding neighborhoods. We have people in our neighborhood that have sent requests to celebrate their mothers also, and they're going to be here sharing with us in this worship experience. So we ask that you would come out and celebrate with us. And last but not least, every Friday at 12 o'clock noon, we're going to celebrate in our Call to Care ministry. Our Call to Care ministry is here every Friday at 12 noon, and we are always lifting up your names in prayer. We know that so many of our people are going through. So many of our people are having hard times. When we see all of this upheaval in our society, in our politics, in our religion, in our communities, the killings, and people suffering with COVID-19, we know that this is a time and a season for prayer. So chime in with us at Mount Calvary. Our phone number is 605-313-4197. And the code is 277725. The code again is 277725. Every Friday at 12 noon. Amen. Reverend Powell read our scripture for this morning. It's a very, very a good scripture, and is relevant for the things that we are experiencing in our society today. I'm doing a series. I started last week doing a series entitled "That About Healing, How Healing Has Come to Us." And last week we talked to you, discussed with you, we asked you the question, how are you feeling? Amen. And today, this morning, we want to continue that series about healing, coming from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 9, verses 35 through 38. Again, that's Matthew chapter 9, verse 35 through 38. I'm not going to read all that Reverend Powell just read to us, but I just want to pull up one particular part of scripture from verse number 35. Matthew chapter 9, verse 35. And it reads, Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness. Now that's the word of God for the people of God. And I'm going to preach to you this morning, and certainly with the help of the Holy Spirit, from this thought. Our healing season has come. Our healing season has come.
All right.
Many of us have experienced physical sickness. Many of us have gone through mental stress and social unrest during this testing season. Unchecked, the cause and effect of these conditions can damage our relationship with the Lord. Our lifeline of hope, faith, and trust in God is served if the damage is left unchecked. Sometimes, my dear brothers and sisters, when these damages occur in our society, when these damages occur in our social conditions, sometimes left unchecked, it isn't easy to reverse them, especially when all hope of healing is gone. We, by nature, react to such turmoil by trying to create our healing mechanism that will ensure that we can survive. All of us, you and I, me included, you and I, we all try to create those things that we can have assurance that we're going to live until tomorrow. You see, self-preservation without God's healing prescription can be depleted and it can be barren. And when barrenness occurs in our lives, we are unproductive, we become lifeless, with no inspiration to move beyond our terrible condition. Yet, according to our text this morning, ordinary people in the days of Christ, they experienced such conditions. The people in the days of Christ, they lived with no hope. They lived with no enthusiasm. They lived with no inspiration that their healing season would ever come. Yes, my brothers and sisters, not only did they exist in horrible living conditions, but they also lost hope and all expectations that their long-awaited Messiah would come to bring to their terrible condition. They were afraid that the Messiah would never come to bring them peace and deliverance from their oppressors. The people could not see. They could not see. They had spiritually blinded eyes. They could not even fathom or see that the kingdom of God was among them through Jesus Christ. Yes, Jesus, my brothers and sisters, in case you didn't know it, he has the authority to heal us. That's why I say this is the season where our healing has come, because Jesus, through the power of the Holy Spirit, has the authority to heal us all. No matter what you may be going through, no matter what your sickness may be, Jesus can heal. Through Christ, the kingdom plans to bring salvation and hope to a hopeless and lost society. Jesus' presence in the world represents a loving and compassionate God. If you ever want to see, and if you ever want to know how loving and compassionate our God is, just pick up your Bible and begin to read about the life of Jesus. Our faith in God can bring peace and healing to a broken and wounded society. Yes, brothers and sisters, in case you didn't know it, our society, you can watch it on CNN, you can see it on MSNBC, you can turn on the news, on headline news, you can see it, you can listen to it on the radio, our society is broken and it is wounded. But listen, just like Jesus did in this text, we too can have faith that our healing season has come. Because when I begin to read my Bible, Brother Thomas, I begin to read about the woman who had an issue of blood for 12 long years.
Yes, sir.
Yes, but by faith, she said in her mind, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I know my condition. With my condition, I will be made whole. So the Bible says she went behind Jesus and she touched him on his tassels and her blood dried up. Yes, Jesus has the power to heal a wounded and broken society.
Yes, he does.
Because the Bible tells me that while Jesus was there and the woman was touching his garment, it talks about a man named Jairus. Jairus comes to Jesus and he wanted the Lord to come to his home quickly because his little daughter was near death. And when Jesus got to the home of Jairus, he took in the house with him Peter, James, and John. And when Jesus got into the house of Jairus, his little girl was already dead. But by her father's faith, Jesus woke his little daughter up from her sleep. Yes, Jesus has the power to heal the broken and wounded society. But not only that, in chapter 9 of Matthew, it talks about how two blind men, they were on the side of the road one day. And they heard that our Lord Jesus was passing by, and they cried out to him, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on us. And Jesus says, according to your faith, you are healed. So yes, here it is again, my brothers and sisters. Jesus came into the world to reveal the real intent of the law. And the real intent of the law of God is this. You should love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and your mind. And the second one is likened to this, that we should love our neighbors as ourselves.
Yeah.
In other words, what I'm trying to get over to you this Sunday morning is that love is the center of the law of God.
Right.
And when Jesus appeared, people who dwell or who live in darkness, the Bible says a great light has dawned. That means those who were in the corridors of life and they had no hope and they had no enthusiasm. Yet when Jesus walked in their condition, a light had dawned. A light had brightened up in their terrible condition.
Yeah.
And that's what it says here in the scriptures, my dear brothers and sisters. It says, Jesus went through all of the towns and villages. What was he doing? He was teaching in their synagogues. He was proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and healing every sickness and disease. And it says, and when he saw the crowds, when he looked at them and saw them, it says he had compassion on them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. And I want to tell you, first of all, brothers and sisters, before I let you go, these few verses are an indictment of the religious leaders who did not take care of God's sheep. But these two verses, I tell you, brothers and sisters, they say a lot about our God. They say a lot about our good shepherd in this, our healing season. You say, well, Pastor Gavin, what do you mean? What is it saying? What is the Lord saying to me that I can say to others to encourage others that our healing season has come? Well, when I begin to look at what Jesus did, first of all, they said he came teaching and proclaiming the good news. He came teaching and proclaiming the good news. What was he teaching and what was he proclaiming? Well, first of all, I want to suggest to you this morning that he was teaching and proclaiming a word, number one, of encouragement.
Yes, sir.
You see, Brother Thomas, anytime we are down, anytime you're talking to people that are down, they need a word of encouragement.
That's right.
And the word of encouragement for all of us today is that God is no longer thought of as being in a far distance, but God is here right now. That's why we used to sing a song in the old days. You don't have to call them loud. You can whisper a little prayer in the morning.
Yeah.
You can whisper a little prayer at noon. You can whisper evening. Why? Because God is not far off. You don't have to yell at him. You can just whisper a little prayer. Why? Because our God is near. Now, gee, that's a word of encouragement.
Yeah.
But not only was Jesus teaching and proclaiming a word of encouragement, but our Lord was giving them a word of empathy.
Uh-huh.
Can you say empathy? Empathy. Listen, a word of empathy is different than a word of sympathy. God sympathizes with us because we can't help ourselves. But also God empathizes with us. Empathy simply means that God cares for us so much that he decides to share in our struggles. And when I begin to look at Jesus, brothers and sisters, I begin to see a God who empathizes with my tears. I see a God who empathizes with my pain. I see a God who empathizes with our struggles. So not only did Jesus preach and proclaim a word of encouragement, not only did Jesus preach and proclaim a word of empathy, but lastly, he preached and he proclaimed a word of enlightenment that through all of our struggles,
yeah,
through all of our pains, the word of enlightenment is that now in this season, God is ready to do something about it. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
But not only did it say he went teaching and proclaiming, but number two, it says he was healing every disease and sickness. Now, it didn't say some disease and sickness. It said every disease and sickness. And I want to tell you that this is the activity of the power of God to straighten out what sin has done. You see, living conditions in the days of Jesus were poor. They were horrible living conditions. But when Jesus came through, the Bible teaches us that the deaf began to hear.
Yeah.
When Jesus came through, the blind were able to see.
Yes, sir.
Can I get a witness here? Listen, when Jesus came through, it says fevers, people who had hot fevers, the fevers were decreased.
Mm-hmm.
The dumb would be able to speak, and the dead shall be raised. He was healing every disease and sickness. But not only was he proclaiming and teaching, and not only was he healing every disease and sickness, but the Bible said he had compassion on them.
Yes.
Don't you know, brothers and sisters that are watching? Don't you know, brothers and sisters that are listening to me this morning, that God is a compassionate God?
Yes.
This simply means that it displays the emotions of God. It displays the emotions of how much God loves us, number one, and desires to save us, number two.
Uh-huh.
Did you not know God has emotions? Every now and then God gets angry. Every now and then God has compassion. And in this particular text, he had compassion on them through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And it made me kind of happy this morning that out of all that we go through, out of all that we suffer with, out of all our conditions and our struggles, that God still sees us and he has emotions for us.
Yes, sir.
So for us today, what does it say for us in the 21st century? Well, it says that Jesus came to heal us. And I believe in all my heart that this is the time and this is the season that our healing will occur.
Yes, sir.
But first of all, Brother Thomas, we must let go and let God do it. Because every time I tried to do it, I messed up. Can I get a witness? But we got to let go of it and give it over to the Lord.
Yes, sir.
The time is now, dear brothers and sisters, to give our hurt, to give our pain over to the Lord. Our Lord Jesus is the only one that can heal our wounded spirits. Our Lord Jesus is the only one that can regulate our confusion. Our Lord Jesus is the only one that can bring justice to our societal sufferings. Only the power of the Holy Spirit can forgive our sin sickness and bind up our external diseases. There have been many people that have been in the hospital. I talk to many of my people on the phone and they have external diseases, but I want to bear witness to you today that God can heal, and this is your time and this is your season for healing. The people in Jesus' day, like people in our today, they felt politically oppressed.
shepherd appears, he finds the lost sheep. And I don't know about you this morning, but I got to bear witness to you today that that one lost sheep was me. And when he finds the one lost sheep, he brings the sheep back home.
Yes,
I want to tell you that our healing season has come. So how does God heal us? Well, let me tell you how God heals us, and then I'm going to bid you good morning. God heals us in this season by faith to know, number one, that God can do it. How do you know this morning that no matter what the problem is, no matter what the confusion is, I have to have a witness this morning to know that God, can you say it? God can do it. Yes, he can. Can you raise your hand and say amen? Say, God can do it.
Yeah.
But not only can God do it by faith, after we know that God can do it, listen, we are assured and know that God has done it. Not only can God do it, but I believe that God has done it. You might not know it now, brothers and sisters. I'm just here to encourage you as your pastor and as your friend that God has done it. So people may say, well, Pastor, I don't know what you mean by that. But the Bible says, by his stripes, listen, it says, by his stripes, we are healed. It didn't say we were going to be healed. It didn't say wait till tomorrow you're going to be healed. It says, by every stripe that Jesus took, headed to Calvary, we are healed. And by faith, I believe that we are healed. That's why I can tell you right now before I take my seat that our healing season has come. Because when I look at Jesus at Calvary, I realize that I'm healed.
Yeah.
I might have to go through some trouble. I might have some ups and downs. People may walk away and leave me. Might have some back and forth with other people. May feel some pains in my body. May have a terrible headache. May have struggles in my spirit. But that doesn't bother me now because I believe that God has done it through confession of faith. He has healed us.
Uh-huh.
And once we know that God can do it, once we know that God has done it, then we must be convicted and prepared to work and witness during harvest season. In the scriptures, the Bible tells us the harvest season represents the last judgment of God. It's an end time message. The harvest is when God gathers us all who are saved. No more crying, no more dying. I want to tell you, this is not only our season of healing, but this is harvest time. It's a time of reaping what was sown. Harvest is symbolic today for us. It is God's provision for us and God's blessings for us. And I don't know how many I have here this morning. You can lift your hands in your home or wherever you may be. You say, well, Pastor, I feel blessed. And not only do I feel blessed, Pastor, I know I'm blessed. I know God has provided for me when no one else could. I know God has blessed me above measure. I want to tell you, Pastor, I feel it right now in my spirit. This is my healing season. Last but not least, then he said to his disciples, he said, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. He says, ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. And I want to tell you this morning, as time is winding up, I don't know who you are, I don't know where you've been, but I want to remind you that time is winding up. Can I give a witness? And I believe our healing season is not only for us. I don't believe that God just saved us to be selfish. I don't believe our healing season is all about us. But I believe that the harvest in this healing season is sharing the good news with other people. Because I realize when I turn on the news, I realize when I listen to the radio, I realize when I walk out in the community, Jesus asks the question, he asks the question, he says, will God send harvesters into the vineyard? Will he find workers that will go out into the harvest field to go tell somebody what the Lord can do and what the Lord has done? Because when I begin oh God. I find that there are many people who are lost and need salvation. I want to let them know that their healing season has come. I want to tell people that I'm living hopeless lives. I've talked to many people who have no hope for tomorrow. I want to tell them that their healing season has come. I realize there are many people that are living in sin and shame. But I got to bear witness as a harvester in God's harvest field.
God, they can come on and be a part of this wonderful and awesome ministry.
Father, I pray for all of those who are saved, those who are saved, those who are baptized in your name, but are still going through, God. I pray healing in the name of Jesus. God, they're saved. God, they're part of this royal family. But yet still Satan won't leave them alone. He keeps plugging with them. He keeps tugging with them, trying to draw them back to where they used to be. But I pray, God, that you keep them steady on this tedious journey. And although we may have highs and lows, God, we know that in this healing season, that everything is going to be all right. I pray for every member of our Calvary, every person, every man, woman, boy, and girl. I pray for all of the members of this wonderful ministry. I pray, God, that you keep them and guide them. I pray for all of our covenant partners, all those who chime in with us all across the country. God, I pray that you will hold them in your hand and keep them from falling. God, continue to lift them and guide them and help them to understand that by the stripes of Jesus, we are healed. Now, God, bless us and keep us, and we shall be blessed and kept. Save us, and we shall be saved. Heal us, and we know that we are healed. Until we gather again in your name, hold us and guide us. In Jesus' name I pray, and the people of God said amen. Amen. I pray that in the name of Jesus, as we talk about our healing season, or that our healing season has come, no longer should you walk around with your head down. Lift your heads to the hills from whence cometh all of our help, for we know that our help comes from the Lord. And I ask that you have a wonderful, and I pray that you have a wonderful and awesome Sunday morning. Go and tell somebody that their healing season has come. Let's look to the Lord to be dismissed. Now, Lord, keep us and guide us, and cause your face to shine upon us and give us peace. Now, may the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit now rest, rule, and abide with us until we meet again. In Jesus' name we pray. And all of God's children said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Have a wonderful and awesome day. We'll see you soon.